exercise.
Yeah.
So you and I talk a lot about exercise when I'm coming to see you in your office. You know, there's lots of 20 minute exercise programs out there, hour programs. I've tried Orange Theory lately, and they're telling you got to get your heart rate up into this orange zone for 12 minutes.
Get some splats.
Get some splat points. What's the best practice out there right now? How many minutes a day or a week should you have your heart rate over your 82-83%?
Yeah, the good news about, well, I'd say it's similar to talking about diet. One apple a day in your diet is an upgrade, and one salad a day in your diet is an upgrade. You know, the American Heart Association is 22 minutes a day of exercise. So you want to do an hour, you want to take 2.5 hours to get ready for the gym, drive to the gym, do a whole gym scene. Any exercise you do, from standing at your desk to walking to the hall to parking further to climbing stairs, natural movement, that's what's called the blue zones kind of concept, that these longevity areas in the world that are like Kevin's grandparents, three of the four of them, you know, nobody's going to a gym. They're doing natural things. All that's said and done, so I'm really big into, you know, so-called hacking exercise, high-intensity protocols, 3-4 times a week.
The HIIT programs.
You know, the Tabata protocol that CrossFit made famous. If you're of good back and hips and joints and all, you know, doing something really hard on an elliptical treadmill bike for 30, 45 seconds back and off for 20, really hard, is very time efficient. And you get the same benefit in terms of your cholesterol, your blood sugar, your weight, and some of your training as you do on a rather boring 30, 40 minutes on an elliptical. You see everybody kind of just watching TV on. You got to work hard. There's a cool new bike besides the CrossFit called the Carol bike. No financial ties. It's an 8-minute workout. It's expensive to get at home, kind of like the cost of a Peloton. But it's only about a minute of hyper intense exercise, and they've got independent research. So our body responds real well to short, intense exercise.
Can't you just use a jump rope?
Yeah, you could. A jump rope, it would be an awesome workout. It's a whole body workout. You could do like really hard for a minute, back off and catch your breath and really hard, or just do really hard for a while. I would try really hard not to hurt yourself. I think that's the biggest mistake. Getting a trainer, you're not ready, being pushed. Next thing you know, your back's out and you're not working out for 2-3 months. That's a mistake. All your trainers out there listening, don't hurt people. Or make sure your client understands. And, you know, do something almost every day and make no excuse if it's 15 minutes in a hotel gym. If you're dropping on the floor and doing 50 push-ups, if you're doing, you know, 25 sit-ups, do something. And I do a whole crazy routine of some weights and some cardio. I've got these vibrational whole body plates called power plate. I love kind of weird exercise. And natural walking whenever you can. Anytime you can be out in nature getting exercise, it's a bonus. Fresh air, it's good stuff.